Number five, it's a slower time of year. You'll find some seasons are busier than others, and for most speakers, spring and fall are when most conferences and events happen. So summer and winter are pretty slow. Going back to our hotel analogy, if it's a slow season and you're trying to entice clients, you may lower your costs or create some incentive. Number six, potential product sales. I've had a few events where I actually made more money in product sales than from my speaking fee. If you have a product and sell it at events, you'll begin to get a feel for events where it sells really well. Sometimes, you may just want to get in front of an audience to sell your product and not even worry about a speaking fee. Number seven, lead generation for a back-end product or service. You may have a book, training program, or coaching program, and this event could be a lead generation tool for that resource. You're not actually selling it at the event, but speaking allows you to capture leads that you can later convert into sales. Number eight, video footage. You can negotiate a lower speaking fee with a client in exchange for demo video footage. At many conferences, a film crew is on site, and if you want some of that footage, this may be worth speaking for free. Number nine, to get more practice. This would be the primary reason you speak for free as a beginner. The only way to get better is to practice, and sometimes that means taking what you can get, even if it's nothing. If possible, try to do this locally so you're not out a bunch of money for travel and hotel. Number 10, credibility. TEDx talks are not paid, but there's certainly a big benefit to doing one. There may be other events in your industry similar to that, where being on stage would be a huge boost to your credibility and thus worth speaking for free. Number 11, you want to attend the conference anyway. Sometimes I offer to do a free session in exchange for complimentary admission to a conference I wanted to attend anyway. This way, I at least get a free ticket and some extra speaking practice. Number 12, to build a relationship with the client. If there is a client or company you want to continue to work with, speaking for free at first is a great way to get your foot in the door and to build a relationship. Don't explicitly say, "I'm doing this one for free, but I expect to get paid in the future." But do share what your normal speaking fee for that gig would be and communicate that you hope to do more business with them in the future. One way to negotiate with clients who have smaller budgets is to suggest splitting the cost with another group. A few years ago, I was speaking at a major university. The department hiring me couldn't afford my lowest package, but another department within the university was having an event as well. So the two departments split the cost of a package for two talks, and I delivered one to each. Maybe the HR department could pay for one talk, and the sales department could pay for another. Another option for negotiation is to offer additional value. You could say, "My speaking fee is X, but we can include additional presentations or books or coaching or consulting, etc." This doesn't require lowering your fee, but it may still save them money. Some conferences have different areas within the budget for resources or training. If you include books or a workshop, they may be able to split your fee from their end in such a way that it saves them money in the training or resources department.